This is Michael from eProgrammer.com. Today I'm going to talk about how to write a research paper in 4 steps with example. Many people talk about this topic and many of them did not explain it well. They use a very abstract idea to explain to other people. It is difficult to understand, so in this video, I will be using simple method with examples to explain to you what do you need to know. Step 1. Introduction. In the introduction, you want to answer a few questions. For example, what has been known? Why is your topic important? And what is your idea? Now, assume I want to write a research paper regarding of a chemical powder prosthesis leg, which is like robotic leg helping like those physical disabled people. Assume this is my topic. How am I going to answer those questions? So what has been known? What has been known is like, oh, powder prosthesis leg has been developed for so many years, and scientists is focused on only the electrical powder prosthesis leg. So that is what has been known. Okay, the next question is, why is your topic important? Well, because like, there are many physical disabled people in US and in the world, and the number is increasing every year. Now, the next question is, what is your idea? Since we want to make a chemical powder prosthesis, so we want to find out the advantage of the chemical powder prosthesis. So you can say like, the charging time for the electrical powder prosthesis is very long. Chemical powder prosthesis can be refilled within a few seconds and has a higher power density. So that is the introduction, okay? You are not going to do a research on the powder robotic, but you are going to answer the same question. What has been known? Why is your topic important? And what is your idea? Okay, that is the step one, introduction. Step two, method. Now, it will separate into design and experiment. In the design part, you want to show a picture of the CAD model of the robotic leg. So yes, like how did you design conceptually of the robotic leg? Well, what else? You want to make sure the robotic leg would be able to support a human weight. So you need to write down the equation of the mechanism of the robotic leg. And you also need to find out like, oh, the chemical reaction equation, right? The most important is, if you are making a chemical powder prosthesis, chemical powder robotic leg, you want to make sure the chemical power would be enough to support physical disabled people for walking, right? So you need to calculate the power. So that is how do you write the method under the design? How do you write down the design part of the method, okay? Well, but what else? You only have like the theory back up you at this point. You want to tell people you did do the experiment. So you need to show the picture of the finished chemical robotic leg. So you have to build the robotic leg, okay? You show the picture of the leg and then you write down the procedure. How did you test the leg, okay? So for example, you give the robotic leg for physical disabled people and then they use the leg to walk. Okay, now that is the design and experiment under the method, okay? Again, you are not going to design a robotic leg, but your paper would be the same. Under the method, write down the design and experiment. How did you do the design? How did you do the experiment? Okay? The next part, step 3, result. Now, in the result is, you want to compare what you get from the robotic leg to the normal people. So you need to prove like your robotic leg is really able to do what it's supposed to do. In the robotic leg, you build it, you ask the physical disabled people to wear it and then get some data, right? So you need to plot the data, plot the experiment data, okay? Plot the walking data, okay? Now, but the key is, you need to compare the physical disabled people walking data to the normal people walking data. Why? Because you want the physical disabled people where your robotic leg can walk as normal as the normal people, right? So that is the data analysis and comparison part. Again, you are not building a robotic leg, but data analysis and comparison is what you need in the result, okay? Last part would be the conclusion. What did you find in this research? And what do you think to do next to improve the research? Now, so the conclusion in here is a making a short summary of what you have done and what has been achieved and also what is different than the previous people and how successful your experiment, something like that. So in here, I write down chemical leg can help physical disabled people to walk. Oh yeah, because like most of the scientists focus on electrical leg. My chemical leg can help physical disabled people to walk, okay? And what else? Because like the chemical power can last longer than the electrical power and the refill time is much shorter. So that is also what you found. If that is what you found, write it down, okay? What do you think to do next to improve the research? Okay, so you may say like, okay, for this time, I use the chemical A plus chemical B to generate the power. But actually, chemical A plus chemical C can generate higher power and the volume is smaller. That is something like, oh, if you do this experiment, again, what will you do to improve it? Okay, and then what else? You can say like, oh, I want to redesign the mechanism, the structure of the leg in order to lower down the weight and make the physical disabled people carry less weight. That is also, you can write it down in the conclusion part. Do you have any question? Do you have any project you need help? Contact us.